You know the story. The recent recession saw employers laying off full-time staff. Filling the gap, the so-called gig economy, where workers take temporary jobs where and when they choose for however long they choose.
Mark Hedges doesn't have a job. He has dozens freelancing in the gig economy. Today, he's patching walls at an apartment in Brighton.
You're not devoted to one company, so it's pretty great. You can do an array of different things. The flexibility, work when I want, deal one-on-one with customers, all that came into play, and it was just a perfect fit.
The gig economy offers freedom and flexibility, but it can come at a cost.
You don't get vacation or if I get sick. So if I don't work, I don't get paid.
Tara Cleary used to work in the corporate world until the financial crisis of 2008. Now she goes from job to job, often listing her services on sites like TaskRabbit. Tara's first stop today, Sapa Vietnamese Kitchen in the Financial District.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing well.
Being able to book people on demand on a freelance basis has been a huge help for us. You know, we get a lot of catering orders, and we don't know how many come in day by day, and you know, I can't keep drivers on waiting for deliveries, so a lot of times we'll use a company like TaskRabbit, and it's been a great help logistically for our restaurant.
I think this is just another form of what people have already been doing. You know, people who have a specialty and go into consulting for themselves and get different clients. I'm gonna try to make it work as long as I can.
The thing we have to watch out for is if there becomes too big a tendency to swap out an industrial era job for a different looking one, simply to save money, simply to cut back on benefits or healthcare that you have to supply to that person.
The catering order delivered, Tara's now off to her next gig, packing up rooms.
Hi. Hey, you must be Annie.
The work's not always glamorous, but Tara finds satisfaction in completing each task.
I discovered that I really like to do jobs that have a completion point and also that make the people that I do it for happy. It's fulfilling a need for them.
And speaking of the future of work, just listen to attorney Ann Straval Schmidt, Tara's employer for the day.
I work for an aerospace and defense company, and I cyber commute to work from my home. The type of work I do, they only want really the product and being available on the phone, and they don't really need to see me. So I think that that's a way of a lot of companies are going because office space is very expensive.
Nanotechnology, genetics, robotics, where this all leads and what the future of work is, who knows? Because as Mark Twain once observed, it is difficult to make predictions, particularly about the future.
So just how big is the gig economy? The Bureau of Labor Statistics said this month that more than 16 million people could be classified that way, including freelancers, independent contractors, and temporary agency workers, among other categories. That is Chronicle for tonight. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Shayna Seymour. Have a wonderful weekend, and we hope to see you right back here on Monday night.